keeping them honest, the president's case that this is a witch hunt, a ruse, or a hoax just got weaker. A new string of indictments from Russia's special counsel Robert Mueller's grand jury sees to that. Now, we should say that indictments are not convictions and allegations are not proof. That said, they do pack quite a punch. They hit on a day that saw another alleged Trump mistress and mistress payoff scheme come to light, a day that also saw the FBI admit to fumbling a tip that might have prevented the Parkland school shooting, a day that ends with the president visiting survivors and first responders there tonight. It's been quite another Friday news day, dominated now by the indictment and the president's less than honest reaction to it. The indictment names 13 Russians for meddling in the 2016 presidential election to help make Donald Trump president, alleging they communicated with unwitting people tied to the Trump campaign. According to the Department of Justice, not a hoax. And although Jessica Schneider will get into more detail shortly, and so will our panels, here's the nub of it. It alleges that these 13 Russians, including a tycoon known as Putin's chef, using an online organization operating out of St. Petersburg, Russia, conspired to illegally disrupt the very thing that makes a democracy. Reading from the bill, quote, defendant organization had a strategic goal to sow discord in the U.S. political system, including the 2016 U.S. presidential election. Defendants posted derogatory information about a number of candidates, and by early to mid-2016, defendants' operations included supporting the presidential campaign of then-candidate Donald J. Trump, Trump campaign, and disparaging Hillary Clinton. According to the Justice Department, not a hoax. Here's Deputy Attorney General Rod Rosenstein announcing the charges.
The defendants allegedly used that infrastructure to establish hundreds of accounts on social media networks such as Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter, making it appear that those accounts were controlled by persons located in the United States. They used stolen or fictitious American identities, fraudulent bank accounts, and false identification documents. The defendants posed as politically and socially active Americans, advocating for and against particular candidates. They established social media pages and groups to communicate with unwitting Americans. They also purchased political advertisements on social media networks. The Russians also recruited and paid real Americans to engage in political activities, promote political campaigns, and stage political rallies.
In other words, not a hoax. A short time later, the president tweeted, and after the tweet, the White House then issued a statement. But first, the tweet, quote, Russia started their anti-U.S. campaign in 2014, long before I announced that I would run for president. The results of the election were not impacted. The Trump campaign did nothing wrong. No collusion. 10 minutes later, the statement from the White House, unlike the tweet, one portion of it does make mention of the country, not just the Trump campaign or his victory or himself. Quote, we must unite as Americans to protect the integrity of our democracy and our elections, says the president in the statement. The rest, though, is along these lines. Quote, it's time we stop the outlandish partisan attacks, wild and false allegations, and far-fetched theories, which only serve to further the agendas of bad actors like Russia and do nothing to protect the principles of our institutions. In other words, Russian meddling isn't the problem. Calling light to the meddling is. Investigating it is, in their opinion. Going by the president's statement, it seems that even saying that it happened damages the very institutions we should be protecting against a threat that has certainly not gone away. And keeping them honest, actually stopping the next attack does not seem to be a priority. Listen to FBI Director Christopher Wray before the Senate just 3 days ago.